Interloper. The hardest difficulty in the game. Let's give it a shot. Never played on this difficulty, but I thought, you know what, maybe I can give it a go and see what happens. It all really depends on where I spawn. From what I've heard, it kind of fucks you over right from the beginning. Where am I? Forlorn Muskeg. That's not good. Forlorn Muskeg is not good. I have practically no clothing on. And it feels like -2 degrees. That's awesome. Alright, so right off the bat, not good. Where's the railroad? It's out that way. Okay, well, freezing to death is gonna be what does me in. It feels like 14 degrees when I'm not in the wind, but I can't stay out either way. Okay, here's the train. I think we're actually next to the loading area. I really hope I am. If I can get into, if I can get into Mystery Lake, I think, I might actually be able to survive for a day or two. Maybe. Isn't there a dead guy over here? A box or something? It's firewood. That's it? Is there anything else? Apparently not. Okay. I'm gonna freeze to death if I stay out here. And I know this is kind of an abrupt intro and just immediate jump into this whole, you know, series, but Interloper doesn't screw around. I'm already, yeah, about to freeze to death. Well, start. I'm almost about to start freezing. And you don't start with anything. Like, you just have clothes, and that's it. You don't get matches. You don't get equipment. You get nothing. So you can't really afford to stand around. I've watched people play it enough. Starts you off. I don't think it starts you off in the middle of the day like every time. I think it's just a chance. But, there's a connecting area here between this and Mystery Lake, and I don't know if I can actually get through this next part quick enough.
Can't feel my feet.
Yeah. Yeah. See, this is the problem. I have to get through here too, and I have nothing to start a fire with. Yep. Yeah, I'm gonna start freezing pretty soon. There's a snowman over there.
So cold.
I think there's train cars up ahead. Maybe I can get in those. I don't know if it's going to be enough to warm me up, though, but if I can find clothing, maybe. Not good. I didn't expect it to be good, but not good. I can climb this landslide because I'm coming to it from this direction. I think I can. I'm gonna have to. I can't actually go around. There's no way. I would die beforehand. Thank God. Okay. Still hope for me yet. Come on. I can't stop. I gotta keep going. Keep going. Where there used to be a train car or something here. Maybe I'm just imagining things. Feels like 1 degree. Yeah, I'm probably gonna get hypothermia. No clothing. Fuck me. Another wolf up ahead. Are you kidding me? This mode does not care. I don't know why he's running away. I'm a fucking prime target. Free meal right here, man. Get in, you idiot. It's like 26.
I could use this.
Put him on. Feels like 27. Gotta let the stamina recharge. And then we gotta run for the building down there. My hands. Well, at least I covered them up. Alright. I might be able to save this yet. Maybe. Just let that go all the way up. Okay, let's go. Look at the back real quick. Nothing. Okay, go. Run. We've got to get in that building. It's going to be our only hope of survival. Not this building. Check here. The supplies are very, very, very limited in this difficulty, so I'm not expecting to get much help from searching, but I also can't afford not to. Let's go in here, actually. Okay, crackers. Really need some clothing. Nothing. Light shell. Perfect. To make a fire with either. No matches. All right. Let's go inside. 26 degrees. Alright, so I think I might make it one day if I can get some more damn clothes. There's a chance.
Could end up being useful.
But I really, really, really gotta get some clothing. Anything at all, except for like another pair of gloves, because I don't need two pairs of gloves, but. Well, I shouldn't have said anything. They are better than the ones I have, I guess. Slightly. Broom. Alright, come on, give me some clothes. I don't think I'm gonna need a hacksaw, to be honest. I don't see myself getting that far. Chair, paint bucket, cardboard boxes everywhere. Books and paper. I can start a fire, but at what cost? I mean, and it really does not want to give me any clothing at all, does it? I guess that's part of the challenge, though, isn't it?
Excellent.
I was about to think I may have just screwed myself there by getting stuck in that, but apparently not. And nothing. And there is just no loot.
This could be really useful.
Except for just cloth and leather, which I don't know why I'm carrying a mountaineer. I'm never gonna use that. No chance in hell am I ever gonna have enough stuff to use a mountaineer in there. Painkillers. Fire barrel. I don't know what to do. I simply just do not have any clothing at all. I guess I'd have to start a fire and warm myself up before I do get hypothermia. That's just the long and short of it. Oh, I don't have anything to start it with, though. I have no matches. So, is that it for this place, then? Have I done all I can do? Break these down, but I mean, not quite sure what the point in that would be. This place was gonna be my saving grace, but unfortunately it didn't turn out that way. None of this stuff is helpful. I mean, it's helpful, but it's not helpful enough. The other thing I could do I guess I could take a nap. And maybe being in the bed would warm me up. That's the only thing I know to do. I guess it's the only thing I can do. I'm not seeing a magnifying glass. I'm not seeing matches. I'm not seeing anything at all that would allow me to start a fire. So I can't start a fire. Which means I'm going to freeze to death. But if I get in bed and sleep, the warmth bonus is 9 degrees. That'll get it up to 35. So let's sleep for 3 hours. Maybe I'll warm up a little bit. Okay, we're good. Now it's dark as hell in here. What a start. Oh, there's tea in here. There's matches right there, I'll be damned. I overlooked them. So now I have 12 matches. Oh yeah, I didn't search the filing cabinet. Man, I totally skipped over this room, didn't I? Just a pair of socks or something would be fantastic.
My fingers feel numb.
It's so dark, I can hardly see anything. Well, I'm not really sleepy enough to go to bed yet. I guess I could break this down. It had lantern fuel in it. Tell you what, we're gonna have to... Oh man, I can't see Jack at all. Okay, where's that fire barrel at? Come on. Where is it? Oh man, where's the fire barrel? Come on.
Damn, I'm freezing.
Cloth. Oh, that's the cloth. Okay, where's the freaking fire barrel? I could light a match, but they're so precious that I don't want to waste a match. Damn it. Here it is. Okay.
It worked.
Well, if nothing else, I'll survive one damn day. Maybe not any more than that, but I'll get one day.
Getting kind of thirsty.
Well, here, you can have all the water you'd like. I can always make more. We're getting hypothermia again. Finding that really helped. It's at 99% to 70. Tell you what we probably should do. Let's see, how far away can I get before I... This works, okay. Let's break this down. Perfect. Okay. I need to repair. Let's repair the jeans, I guess. Well, let's try. Oh, I can't. I don't have a sewing kit. Damn it. Never mind. Much for that brilliant plan. I guess I'll just make some more water. Whew, this is rough. Well, I suppose I've done all I can do here. There isn't anything else I can loot or anything. From what I can tell. Man, what a rough game mode this is. It really makes you take for granted the other game modes where it's like at least decently fair. Do a quick look around real quick, make sure I didn't really miss anything. Fire is going to go out in a second, so I don't really have that much time. And this torch won't last long either. Well, if nothing else, I made it one day on Interloper. And I tell you what, if I could get to Mystery Lake, I could probably last another day. If I was a betting man. And I might be able to make it to Mystery Lake. I don't know. It's going to be a close one. It's going to be a very close one. I have a lot of running ahead of me to make it that far. Tell you what I should probably do is break down some of this stuff real quick. I should probably get back to my bed. There we go. So here's the bed. Where's that table at I just saw? I'll tell you what. It is pitch freaking black. Can't see a thing. Where's the bed? Give me a second to find the bed. Here we go. Okay. Phew. We'll sleep as long as it'll let us, but it won't be all night. I can already tell. Woke up rested, and it's still nighttime. Fantastic. Can't see anything. All right, well, screw this. Much as I love sitting in the dark, was the bed? Where was it?
Cold is making my head feel thick.
I get another hour of sleep or two. Well, the sun's coming up, but not nearly as quickly as I'd like. fuel. I got 8 pieces of that, actually. That probably worked. Where you at, Firebell? Barrel, come here. Cardboard box, no, come on.
Can't feel my hands.
Yeah, shut up. I'm working on it. Where's that damn fire barrel? Oh my god. Look, one more hour then. Give me some daylight. I cannot find the damn...
Wait. Die if I don't warm up soon.
Finally, okay. Jesus.
That should help warm things up.
Man, this is rough. Oh wait, I never boiled it. Alright, so I made it one day on Interloper, just about. I'm sure I'll get the achievement in a second. Or actually, no, it started us off in the middle of the day, so I suppose it would give it to us then. I guess. I'm going to end it here, and we'll keep going on to the next one. Thanks for watching. Alright, welcome back. Interloper difficulty stuff. This is fun. I really wanted to break this box down. 1 hour and 30 minutes, well. Do that. Do that. Maybe the fire won't go out. Nah, it didn't. Like that. Oh, and of course, the weather outside. Fantastic. That's exactly what I needed to hear right before I got ready to leave this stupid place. I have a hatchet, you dope. Oh, it's a hacksaw. Here. Okay. Hey, they both started with H's. Man, the weather outside. Really? Right now? All times? Oh, I'm not letting this thing go out again. I think I know what I'm doing. Don't worry. I think I know what I'm doing. Get in those things. Is that a pry bar? It is. Interesting. Let me take a torch. And that should keep me above freezing temperature, I think. 31. Well, it's
all
close.
I can think about is food.
Alright, please give me something. Something, anything. Damn it. Okay, you were lost. I can't get anything. I mean, I know it's part of the difficulty where you're not gonna be gifted everything to survive. God, it's not giving me jack.
Damn it. So hungry.
These torches don't last long either, I've noticed. Thank you. does it for that. Hey, I made it a day. Hell yeah. It's gonna blizzard all day long, and I'm not gonna be able to fucking leave. I'm gonna be stuck here again, and then I'm gonna starve to death. Not really? Come on. All right. Well, it stopped. So, let's do that, and let's warm this up and eat it, and then I have to go. I'm gonna have to run like crazy, too. It still sounds crappy out there, too. Like, it's not as bad, but it still sounds bad enough. I could take a torch, but it's probably gonna go out as soon as I leave, but it doesn't matter. I can't stay. I have to leave. There's nothing else here for me to take. Of course, there would be a wolf right outside waiting for me. I shouldn't be surprised by. He's already given up the chase, but I can't stop to fucking stand here anyways. You know what I just realized, though? I think I'm going in the wrong direction. I think Mystery Lake is actually in that direction, which is the direction I came from. I think. Either way, this leads to, like, the lodge area. So I'm going to a new area anyways. One way or another. At least I'm not completely freezing to death right now. Doing okay. Doing decent, anyways. The fact that I'm still alive is proof in that of itself that I am doing decent. But I would kill for some more damn gloves. Or gloves, clothes. Like, I don't care what they are, anything. Except for gloves, because I already have gloves. Anything except gloves. And the game's kind of just spitting in my face. But this bridge is out, right? Yeah, you actually can't go any further here, can you? Wait a minute. The lodge is back behind where I just was. I remember that now. Yeah. Okay. It was like 10 degrees. Okay, what about if I get here? 25. Oof, that wind is sharp. Okay, well, I've got to keep the wind off of me. Or this is going to go bad. I need to go that way, if I'm going to go to the lodge. I need to go that way if I'm going to go back to Mystery Lake. But I'd have to go through Forlorn Muskeg all over again, which ultimately I'm going to have to do because I can't stay here. I just can't. It's going to kill me if I do. going. Can't stop, won't stop. Even the sticks that fall on the ground are like lessened in abundance on this mode. Because that's free firewood, and the game's like, no, you don't get that. And I'm gonna grab these in case I see a rabbit, but I'm also not counting on that either. I think it's in this direction. It is, okay. Oh no, I can't get in there without wire cutters though. Ah, fudge. I just remembered that. I'm pretty sure this is locked. I can't even get into it. You have to have bolt cutters. Snowman over there. I can't get in here, can I? I can't. Okay. Maybe it was just in the story mode that it had to be cut open. Yeah, that's probably what it was. Okay. See, I haven't been back here since in the story mode, since I played through it on that, so. 8 degrees. Fantastic. If I can get to the lodge, I'll at least be inside and it won't be freezing cold. It'll just be, well, yeah, it actually, it'll still be freezing cold, but it won't be like deathly freezing cold immediately. I probably need to let my stamina recharge because I'm going to bet there's a wolf up here.
I need to find food. Escape this cold.
I guarantee you there's a wolf out here somewhere. I don't see one. Alright, let's run out here real quick. Check this dead body. Actually, if it's a deer, yeah, okay, I can't do anything about that. There's the wolf over there. Okay. There's no cattails out here. Oh, come on. Can I make it to the fucking lodge, please? I think I can. He's coming. But not quick enough. Okay, we made it. 43 degrees, alright, that's what I'm talking about. Another box of matches, all the firewood I could ever need. No food, hardly, like a candy bar. Yeah, okay, let's go downstairs.
Hope nobody needs this anymore.
Some firewood. Oh boy. There's just no supplies at all. And it's so brutal. There's just nothing. Had the means to fish, I might be able to survive. Maybe. If I had a sewing kit, that'd be great too. Ooh. Oh, I thought that was clothing. There's the stim pack I'll probably end up needing. Alright, that room didn't have much in it. I mean, the stim pack is helpful, but if I end up having to use a stim pack, it's probably going to be because I'm on the way out and about to die.
That'll come in handy.
Thank God. Okay, that helps.
I think my stomach is eating itself.
Two of these. My warmth bonus is up to 9 degrees. That's not bad. It's not great. I've had it way higher than that. Another mountaineering rope. I don't know why they're so hell-bent on giving me those. Okay. That does it for this place. How much food do we end up getting? I have a decent amount. Enough to last me, anyways. I don't have anything that I can use for, I have nothing I can use to repair my clothing. I mean, my clothing isn't in terrible shape, but if I had it repaired better, it would be better. It would stave off more wind and all that. Okay, well. Sun's about to start going down anyway, so I guess this is where we're staying tonight. Here. No, here. Can't even stay in that bed. Okay. Let's see here. I don't need 7 of these, so let's go ahead and make tinder out of them. Tinder plugs.
Soon, I'm gonna faint.
Okay, I can drop the guns. Yeah, I pretty much need everything else. I need all that.
My stomach feels like an empty pit.
I don't need that. I can guarantee you there's never going to be a situation in which I can actually afford to use a mountaineering rope in this playthrough. No way. Alright. Calories right here, man. Get your water up. So 8 hours will take all 600 of my calories. Go ahead and eat this. Sleep, maybe my wellness will go up because it's been at halfway this whole time and I don't know if it's actually going up or I don't know what the deal is. Oh yeah, okay, it went up good.
Now.
Yeah, well, you don't have much to choose from, unfortunately. Chance. Yeah, sure. See if we can get one started. I'll warm up that tea, at least, and go from there. I'm actually going to start out early. It may be colder, but I'm not as concerned with the cold anymore, I don't think. It's food that I need at this point. If that wolf's still out here. Yep. Aggressive motherfucker, isn't he? Why are you the way you are? Oh, of course. Damn it. That mouse, that rabbit is really tasty looking. Come here. Put this away. Put it away. No, come here. I got it. What a stone. I can't. I don't do this often enough to know how to do it. Damn it. God damn it, the aiming system in this game is retarded. You stupid mouse. Damn it. I don't use the freaking aiming system to throw rocks in this game enough to actually know how to do it decently, unfortunately. Damn. That was close, though. Alright, well, whatever. Lost my torch, didn't get a rabbit. I came out a double loser there. And it feels like negative 3 degrees outside. That's fantastic. Okay. Whatever. Let's just go. I've got the means to start a fire to warm up again. And I'm gonna need it. No cattails. No cattails at all. Not a one. That's a shame. Gonna keep picking up sticks, I guess. Fuel for the fire. I'm gonna need to keep it from freezing to death. These corpses never have anything. I've like checked probably 30 corpses in this game and only like two of them had anything on them.
Can't feel my feet.
I think I need three. I need to pick three plants in order to get the make the tea. If I need to make the tea, I have the option at least. At least I'm heading in the right direction. I don't know where some of this light's coming from.
I've never been so hungry in my life.
Hypothermia, same as always. I'll be back inside in a second.
So cold. Just want to lay down for a bit.
Where's that wolf at? Cunt. Here he comes. Oh, I could have done that anyways. I did check out those. All right. Well, I'm back in here again. 28 degrees. See if I can find that fire barrel again. Which, knowing my luck, I won't be able to, because, again, it's pitch black. Oh, there it was. Hell yeah, okay. Let's see, just use a stick. 60% chance of success.
Goddamn freezing.
Alright. I hear you. It's cold. I hope I don't waste matches on this, but I don't want to waste lantern fuel on it either. And a 60% chance is better than a 40% chance. We did it. Awesome. It almost immediately burned out, but we did it. Okay.
So hungry.
That's all you get, man. Warm up already, damn it. We have to keep going. We cannot stop. But I will stop for a second to end the episode. Thanks for watching. Okay, welcome back. I don't think I ever checked this truck over here. I'm gonna do that real quick on the way out. I expect this torch to blow out any second. And there's probably nothing in here anyways, but yeah. Alright. So, Interloper is apparently really freaking hard. I've survived two days. And I can probably last a third, but if I don't find any food, it's probably going to be game over. Funnily enough, freezing to death hasn't been my biggest problem, although it is a problem. It was like 10 degrees. Yeah, that's pretty damn cold. Negative 12. Yeah. Let's just go into the wind. Because I have no choice but to go this direction. Of course, there's a wolf. Damn it. Okay, doesn't this flank around, or is that the next one? I think it's the next one. I don't think this one actually flanks to the left. Maybe it does. Does it? No, it doesn't. Anything over here at all? Dead body and a deer. Probably nothing on the body. Nope. And I can't afford to get the deer meat once I build a fire, which, yeah, I'm actually gonna do that. I don't have a choice anymore.
My fingers feel numb. That should help warm things up.
Okay, what? Let's wait an hour for the deer carcass to thaw out a little bit.
Gotta eat soon.
Okay, so now it's not frozen. That'll take 27 minutes. Be our dinner. Taking forever for my guy to get warmed up. I guess it was a good thing that I came this way. Got some free food. It only cost me half of what was left of my lantern fuel. And now we're gonna get attacked by a wolf, probably. If I was a betting man. Don't run with me. Run away from me, dude. Please don't attack me again. He's running right next to me. Look at this fucking wolf. His aggro's gonna run out and he's gonna turn around and do it again. I guarantee fucking to it. That went better than it could have. Oh, great, another one. Yeah. I'm dead. Okay, yeah, I'm dead. Alright, well, that went about as well as expected. Let's see. One day survived? What? No, I lived more than one day. I made 2 days. But I was like, what's the hour count? 29 and 18. 29 and 18 would be... That's well beyond 48. That's right at 48, isn't it? It's 47. Okay, so I didn't make it quite 2 days. Whatever. Creepers on the world. One day in the broken railroad, and that's basically it. Two wolf struggles, 1-1. Now, there's your stats. Made it 3 days on Interloper. So that's it. Thinking I'll probably just have Seth edit these 3 episodes together into one and just, we'll title it something like, you know, The Long Dark, you know, Ambrose's Interloper Experience or something like that. Something stupid. But anyways, I gave it a shot. I got the achievement I wanted for living for 1 day. I'm kind of an achievement grinder, so I'm working on that right now, too. And yeah, I guess that's it. Still got a little bit of learning to do if I want to actually play this game on that difficulty. But I never claimed to be pretty good at the game. Just, I like it. So, thanks for watching.